Hey everybody, what's going on? It's Chris. Just wanted to say hello and welcome to the channel. Welcome back. Today's going to be more of a vlog style video. I have decided to just do something a little bit easier because I'm a little bit under the weather right now. I'll get to that in a little bit. But I asked around on social media if people would send me some questions, just some things they wanted answered about me, whether it was about my life or really anything. I left the book open for whatever people want to know. So I'm going to try to be as transparent and open about things as people want me to be. I got some pretty good questions. I didn't get as many crazy deep ones as I thought I was gonna, which is perfectly fine. People ask what they want to ask, and I'm here in this hotel room right now because I am I'm sick. I don't know that it's COVID. I don't think it's COVID. I've had a few tests. They've all been negative, but my symptoms have been similar to COVID. So more or less, I'm just being a little bit more careful and considerate of my friends who I'm staying with. So I decided to stay at the hotel for a few nights till I'm feeling better. I just didn't want to risk getting anybody sick, you know. It's not really worth it, especially when my friends make money and, you know, they need to be at work to make money, that kind of thing. So just me being just considerate of other people, I guess, you know. So I'm doing okay, though. I have been feeling a little bit under the weather. Cough, headache, a little bit of a fever. Just, I don't know, it hasn't been like a crazy cold, so it makes me think maybe it's not COVID. Like, I haven't been bedridden or anything. I've been sleeping a little bit more than I normally do, but that's nothing that I haven't done before from a cold. I've definitely had worse colds, so it might not be COVID, but I just don't want to get people sick. So figured I'd get the hotel. Here I am. But yeah, just want to say hello, fill you guys in a little bit of my life as well. So I just figured I'd do a little vlog, you know. And it's not very often I'm at a hotel, have like a nice quiet area like this, and like in the conference room. They were nice enough to just let me use it because it's not very busy today, so very nice of them. Shout out to I think this is a Courtyard Marriott, I think. I'm not sure. They're all the same to me. It's hard to remember which one I'm at. So yeah, if I kind of look like I'm a little bit under the weather, don't look like myself. I'm definitely not feeling so hot, but gonna go jump in the hot tub after this. There's no doubt about it. Hit the upload button and I'm gonna go right to the hot tub. I was gonna take some breaks and maybe think about things a little bit, but I think I might just get right into this because it feels like it's rolling off my tongue pretty easy today for whatever reason. So if I do cough and everything, I do apologize. Again, I'm sick. I went through my questions. I made a YouTube community post and I made a tweet just for people to ask me questions, as well as people in my Patreon and Discord. I think I got 35 questions, which sounds like a lot, but I'm not gonna spend a lot of time. So if you guys are interested in this video, totally understand. This is just more of like a get to know me kind of thing. Don't expect everyone to stay, and I just want to upload more content for everybody. So it's not gonna be the same thing every week. It's not gonna be just magnet fishing. It's not gonna be just ghost hunting, that kind of stuff. Do plan on bringing you guys more of that in the future. I want to do some ghost hunting, whether it's by myself or maybe with friends. Magnet fishing, I would love to do more of that. I'm absolutely gonna do more of that. I love magnet fishing. It's just a really good time. What else am I gonna do? I want to clean out cars. I've talked about that a little bit in the past. I don't know why, just something that I've watched and enjoyed. I think it'd be fun to clean out some dirty cars, maybe do some details. Who knows, food, like, my book's open. So again, you guys have recommendations on things you want to see from me, videos you want to see from me, things you want me to try. You know, tech reviews are something that I've always really wanted to do and I haven't gotten into much, so I was able to get a new computer recently, so maybe I'll do a review about that, you know, just something different, like a MacBook review. I don't know, we'll see. We'll see what happens. We'll see what comes up. I like making content. I'm enjoying, not the starlight, I wouldn't call it that, but I like being in front of the camera and chatting and just seeing the comments. Seriously, thanks everybody so much. I know I say it a lot, but I really, really do appreciate every single one of you. Just reading the comments back and good God, you guys are so nice and so kind, especially just to me and just, you know, everything I've been through. It means a lot. You know, if I'm ever having like a little bit of a rough day, I go through and just read some YouTube comments. It just brings my spirits right up because everyone's so genuine and nice and supportive of me and just the path I've chosen and the things that I've done. So I can't thank everybody enough again for being here, for supporting me. It does not need to be monetary. I never asked for that. Just the comments and the love and the messages mean the world to me. So thank you. I know I've been lacking a little bit on catching up with Instagram DMs. So if you guys have messaged me and I haven't responded, I do apologize. I'm going to work on getting caught up on those while I have this time to rest in this hotel. All right. So this one's going to be my first question. This one is from SusieVL09 on Twitter. She said, now that you've moved, what are your future plans? What's next in the life of Chris? So yeah, I moved down here. I'm in Florida, obviously, far away from my family. I am living with one of my closest friends, which is awesome, but I don't really know a lot of people down here, which isn't always a bad thing. You know, it's good to meet people. I've met some pretty cool people so far. But I definitely miss my family. I miss my girlfriend. I miss the dogs and everybody. I'm not saying I'm going to be moving back home or anything. It's not like that. But yeah, I think that I'm going to keep going with this. I'm going to give it a little bit longer because if I'm being honest with you, I don't guess maybe it's not what I thought it was going to be. I don't hate it. It just, I don't know. I guess I thought that you would jump into this job and you would just start like selling houses and it would just be crazy. Money would be coming in. I know you got to work hard for things. I really do. But it's very cutthroat. It's a very, it's hard. It's very hard to sell. You got to be like a special person to really make it in this kind of field. And I'm not saying that I couldn't be that person, but I don't feel like it in my heart. Like that's the person that I am. But again, I'm not going to give up. I'm going to keep trying. And if I'm truly not happy in like a month or two, then maybe I will make a decision. Maybe I'll move back or maybe I'll try something different field. I don't know. At the end of the day, I do love being behind the camera. No doubt about that. I love filming and recording videos. I was fortunate enough to get, become a YouTube affiliate. So I was able to start making a little bit of money on videos now, which just kind of makes it a little bit easier for me because like, I'm not, you know, on like a salary, you know, I'm just like the commission based. Not really making money right now. So every little bit I can make helps. And at the end of the day, you know, why not? If I'm able to make money, I have the opportunity, why wouldn't you? And I don't think anyone would be mad about that. I'm not going to be spamming you guys with like crazy amounts of ads or anything on the videos, but there will be some ads here and there just because it does help me out a little bit. So if you guys do watch through the videos and just leave comments and likes and you know, just keep supporting me like you guys have been, that helps so much. So thank you so much. Again, I'm not doing this for the money, but just makes my life a little bit easier while I'm doing this. And it gives me, it allows me to travel more and go out and do things. And if I want to take like a weekend off and go do something somewhere and I made a few extra $100 last month and I have the money to do that, then I'm gonna, you know, I like to bring better content and explore my own a little bit. That's the thing that's like kind of frustrating a little bit too lately. You know, I get a lot of comments that are like, oh, you know, you said you didn't want to do YouTube anymore, but you're filming with CJ and Dylan. And I never really said I wasn't going to do YouTube anymore. I just parted ways with Jazz, and that's kind of, you know, it was my decision and I had made my mind up. So wanted to go a different route, wanted to do different things. It's kind of all there is to it, you know. So I have no intentions on ever stopping YouTube. I'm not saying that I want to do this forever, or that I want it to be like my only source of income one day. If it does become that, cool. Like, I don't know what my future holds, but again, I want to be successful and make money and pay off my parents' house one day and buy my sister a Jeep truck that she wants. Like I want to get in that position one day to do that kind of stuff. And if it's YouTube or if it's me selling houses, like whatever way, like I have to go to do that, I'm gonna bust my butt and I'm gonna try to make it happen. So I promise you that. So maybe you will see me on YouTube more. I don't know what I'm gonna do. Just kind of like, I'm not gonna say I don't have plans, like a future plan. It's just not like set in stone, I guess, because I'm still getting settled in here. And, you know, a good plan for me would be to have my own place within the next couple months. Get a newer vehicle, save some money, you know, get my girlfriend down here if she wants to come down, hopefully. I mean, she does, obviously. But yeah, I just want to get things figured out. I want the simplest things in life, man. You know, I want a house. I want a, not even a big house. Like, I love the idea of those tiny little houses. That, like, as long as it's got like a 6 foot, 6-7 ceiling, so I'm not hitting my head. But I would absolutely live in a tiny house. I've always thought those were so like fascinating. I don't need the biggest things, the craziest things. At least not yet. I don't have that taste because I don't have a ton of money. It is what it is. There's nothing against that. Maybe it'll come with time. But right now, I would just love to have my own place to live and a nice vehicle and just all my bills paid off, you know. Maybe old Joe will cancel student loans or something. Maybe not. I don't want to pay those off. But for now, I got bills to pay. I got things to do. And I got to make money and get by. So, yeah, it kind of is what it is. So I think I answered that question. Again, just going to keep working, Susie. I'm going to keep working, keep doing my thing, see where Florida takes me. And I'm going to keep filming. I'm going to keep having fun. And, she also asked, what is my favorite scary movie? You can ask anybody. I don't like scary movies very much. They're not my favorite. I did actually see Paranormal Activity. I watched that in theaters when it came out. I had to have been in like middle school or something. That movie terrified me. I don't know. I was just so scared. Mostly because I've had like paranormal experiences in life. Like I've had things happen that make me believe in the paranormal and that ghosts are real. So that movie was very realistic and seemed like, I don't know, I just felt like that movie could have been like a real movie. So that scared me a lot. I watched The Conjuring. I think the newest one. Yeah, we watched the newest one. It didn't scare me at all. I don't know if I just went into it with like a different mindset that like it's all fake and something to worry about or something. Like I always tell myself that. Like it's not real. And then it usually isn't that bad. So sorry, I don't have like a better scary movie for you, but I'm gonna say Paranormal Activity. Next question from Andrew V, Lieutenant 74656. He's a good dude. If you know, you know. he says, what makes Chris tick? Honestly, what makes me tick? It doesn't really take much. If I'm totally honest with you, I love life. Like, life itself to me is so damn good. It's not about the things I have. Well, maybe it is. It's like, you know, I do have health. I have my health. I have my family. I have my girlfriend. I have amazing friends around me right now. That kind of stuff just keeps me going because I just want to be here. Like, if I could, at this point in my life, if I could live forever, I think I would choose to because I just love it. I don't know, I just know the world is so big and there's so much I want to see and do someday. Like, I guess maybe the thought of traveling and, like, seeing the world, maybe that's what keeps me going. I don't think about this stuff a lot. Like, that's a deep question. I wish I had more time and prepared myself more for that. But, yeah, what makes me tick, I'm just going to say friends and family and girlfriend. And, yeah, I just want to keep going. I want to keep just be successful and whatever I do and just be comfortable. I don't need to be the richest person, but if I had money to, again, survive, get by, if I could pay off my parents' house one day, that would be like the greatest feeling because they've literally done everything they could for me, always. They still are trying to do everything they can for me. You know, you don't forget that stuff. So love you, Mom and Dad. Thanks for everything you guys do. Let's see. Bambara Diana 2 said, what can run but can't walk? What has a ring but no finger? What has an eye but can't see? I could probably sit here all day and think about that, but I'm sorry. It's not coming to me. It could be the sickness. I don't know. how many brothers and sisters do you have? I have one sister. My sister's name is Paige. She's a younger sister. She's a few years younger than me. And then how did I meet Yasko? I met Yasko when we used to work at Best Buy together. That story's been told a bunch. But yeah, we used to work at Best Buy together. So, and then we were just friends and played video games together, and that all worked out that way. So, I just redid this because I just had a coughing attack because I didn't have my coffee. I got my coffee nearby now, so we're good. I had to wet my whistle a little bit. But I have asked what the worst thing was that's happened to me in my personal life or school years. And, you know, it's been pretty much usual stuff. You know, I've lost two grandparents. I lost my godfather when I was younger in school. I think I was in, like, middle school, elementary school. I was pretty young. Losing pets, I was in my first car accident a few years ago. It was pretty bad. I totaled the vehicle at work, and that was one of the worst days of my life, just because I was alone, I was away from home. Nobody came to the scene of the accident, because everybody was, like, an hour away, and they were able to get there, so, that car accident definitely, like, I was okay. I had, like, just a little bit of, like, whiplash, like, shoulder injury, nothing crazy, but anytime you know, it was my first one, and it was scary, very scary, being by yourself, rainy, cold day in November, nobody around, you know, like, I had to ride back an hour to town, because I was delivering tires back then, and, I had to drive back to town with, like, the tow truck driver, didn't know the guy, he saw him just talking to me and stuff, he was a nice guy, but just kind of, like, a very lonely feeling, you know, it's a scary moment when you get in an accident, so that wasn't fun at all, so, yeah, that was probably, that right there was probably the worst moment so far. Did you know you wanted to be a cameraman? Yes, I actually did. So this is related to like my motocross background. I always used to watch like old motocross movies, like The Prospects, The Beginning. They were actually made by Wes Williams, who's a very prominent cameraman, videographer, editor, and all that in the motocross and action sports industry. Essentially, Wes Williams is incredibly talented, and I've always looked up to him. I really have. I always wanted to make movies, motocross edits. I used to make little ones in my backyard, and I like they're still on one of my old YouTube channels somewhere. They were awful, but I would go to the races or go around and just make, you know, little video edits and film, and they were all right. Like, I used to love matching up like the music with the clips, so they would all like transition when the beat would drop, that kind of thing. But I was never, I guess I never had good equipment. Never had equipment that would like get people's attention. So I guess like, maybe I didn't like go after it enough, but I've always had cameras and video equipment in my life. I always loved taking pictures and videos. So I guess I'm fortunate now that as I'm getting older in life, I'm actually able to do that. You know, and if I do run more trips in the future with CJ and Dylan and they want me to help them, I'm absolutely gonna, because I love being behind the camera. The ghost stuff can be scary at times, but when I get to film and you know, be with my friends, that's always a good time. So she also said, were you clever at school? I don't want to like pat myself on the shoulder or anything, but you know, no, I think I was like a pretty smart kid for the most part. I was always like an A-minus student. Never really applied myself like I should. You know, I didn't really do my homework on time. That was definitely not right. Like, if I could go back, I would absolutely do my homework and study for tests. And I really don't think I ever studied and did like anything along those lines. I was that kid, always like to go home and just play video games all day. And looking back, it wasn't my best move. But yeah, I definitely think I could have done more and probably been a lot better in school and had better grades and maybe gotten scholarships and college rides and everything. Just didn't apply myself, so it is what it is. Definitely would recommend that people in school would stay in school and study and do your homework, because it's very important. I got 93, I got a 93 on my Earth Science Regents exam, which is like our state test in New York at the end of the year, like a Regents throughout grade school, you'd have those. It would just test your, you know, every different curriculum kind of thing. So, Earth Science was like one of my best areas in math as well. But I didn't test well in math for whatever reason. So, my ultimate goal in life is, again, just to be successful, pay off some family bills, and just have money, be comfortable, and get to travel. I love traveling. So, thanks to Hub for that question. Monkey Grease asks, hi Chris, how did you get started riding dirt bikes and racing them? So the dirt bike thing was actually mostly my dad. I there's pictures and videos somewhere of me, you know, getting put on the dirt bike when I was probably like a year or two old, you know, and I was terrified of it. I hated it. I'm pretty sure I was like screaming the first time I got on it, and changed pretty quick, you know. Eventually I wanted my own bike. But my dad grew up with, you know, mopeds and snowmobiles and all that crazy stuff. They would wreak havoc on their town where they grew up. So my dad and all his friends. My mom even had dirt bikes when she was growing up too. We actually still have one of her. I don't know if it was her first dirt bike or I always forget the story. But we still have it. I actually rode it a few months ago. It's a good little bike, a Kawasaki KE100. But yeah, like just kind of grew up in the family, and it's just an addiction. It's one of those things that, I don't know, once you ride and you ride a lot, and you just can't get enough of it, you know. It's the adrenaline rush, it's just the hitting the jumps, the turns, and I love it. And racing is just the competitive side of me, you know. Like, I'm very competitive, and I got better at riding growing up. I wasn't great by any means, but I got better and practiced a lot and wanted to go race. You know, my dad raced, and I was like, I want to be just like my dad. So that's how that came about. And yeah, I'm still doing it. I don't ever plan on stopping. You're going to find me when I'm like 80 years old, still jumping on the bike somehow. I'm sure there'll be a way. Aussie Girl Donna said, have you given away Randonautica and ghost hunting for good? Absolutely not. Again, I'd like to do some more ghost hunting in Randonautica as well, because Randonautica is super fun. It can be a good app to use and play. And there's a million things you can do with the app and ask and look for and seek. So if you guys don't have Randonautica on your phones right now, download it, play it, use it, because it'll be fine. Nothing's going to happen to you. It can be a really, really good app if you, you know, try to look for good, positive things. And highly recommend everyone play some Randonautica, especially when you're bored. If you have nothing to do, even if it's like a rainy day, like, just go play. Why not? Go out and play. Get in the car or go for a walk and just see what you can find. I mean, you really never know. There's some cool stuff, some hidden gems out there you did not know existed, so. I have the coffee. Shout out to us at the Hampton. We're at a Hampton hotel. All right, next question. What has been your most terrifying, scared for your life moment on or off camera? Nothing off camera has really been like scared or terrifying. On camera is probably the ghost stuff, you know, like doing the ghost hunting, like the Shanley was pretty scary. I don't know. The Shanley, Pennhurst was definitely pretty creepy too. I think Indiana though, like so far for me has been the scariest. Indiana, with CJ and Dylan. Holy cow, that place was wild. It was the most active. I don't even know how to describe it. Just, again, you walk in that place and you just don't feel safe or alone. Like, I literally got chills right now in my legs just talking about it. You ever guys ever get that? Do you ever get chills just talking about, like, paranormal experiences? Because I get it all the time. I don't know. It makes me, like, it's not uncomfortable, but it's like, whoa, dude. I gotta cut this video down soon, too. I've been talking way too long. I'm so sorry, guys. Will you be doing any more magnet fishing or haunted videos? That's from Debbie Lane. Yes, I definitely will. I do talk to CJ and Dylan about every day now. We Zoom talk on like meetings and stuff, and I kind of help them out. I wouldn't say I help them out, but we have like creative meetings and we talk about things. Cause again, people who hate on me for talking to CJ and Dylan were my friends as well. They weren't just, you know, Jazz's friends. So, I wish people would respect that because, you know, I went to Busco with CJ. He invited me on that trip. Like we are friends. We can all be friends individually. We don't have to just be like friends of friends, you know? And again, like Jazz doesn't talk to me anymore. So like, I'm not friends with them for that reason, but we were already friends in the first place. So, they've been with me and supporting me and they've been so helpful with me on this journey, with my questions and moving in Florida and, just everything. So CJ and Dylan are, they're amazing friends. I'm just glad to have them in my life right now. So that's all I can really say about that. I definitely plan to film with them more in the future. I think we're actually planning like a little trip in January somewhere, so I don't want to spoil that, but you might see me with the boys again, sometime soon. So, geez, January is not far away either. 2022 is on the horizon, folks. Get ready. I'm gonna do a New Year's video, I think, talking about my goals because I fell really short of my goals last year. Well, this year actually. So, I want to make some new goals for next year and do some bigger things. How are you liking Florida? Florida's good. It's warm. I love the warmth and the heat. I don't like the traffic. I'm not a huge fan of the people so far. The people that I have to work with in my like community, not my favorite people. They're not very like polite from what I've experienced so far. But that is what it is, part of the job, I guess. Lots of things to do, lots of places to eat. I love, the little lizards that run around. Those like tiny little, I don't know, they zip across. They're so fast. I love those little lizards. They're so funny. They're way better than like bugs and like ants and stuff at back home in New York. So I'll take the lizards all day. Should do some magnet fishing. I've gone magnet fishing a few times down here and haven't found anything. Like it's so weird. The first couple times I went up in Delaware and back in New York, like I found some cool stuff, but just like nothing down here. I don't know. I gotta find some like more public spots, I guess. I don't know. But I'll try to do some more videos for you guys soon. Nikki asks, should I join the Stormcloaks or the Imperials in Skyrim? I'm gonna Google that right now. Stormcloaks or Imperials in Skyrim. Let's see what we got. It's hard to tell. It doesn't really show me anything. I'm gonna say Stormcloaks because it sounds cooler to me. Yeah, that's what I got for you. Join the Stormcloaks. I have no idea what that even means. Explain the Krebs cycle of energy production from Cody Berry. Cody, I'm not that smart, man, all right? I don't know what that means. I'm sorry. I'll do some research and I'll get back to you next time, okay? Maggie asks, hey, Chris, what came first, the chicken or the egg? Yes. Emma Jane asks, hey, Chris, how tall are you? I'm 6'4" and shrinking. I can already tell I'm shrinking. My back hurts every day. I got to be shrinking. Sunshiny Daisy. Kay, her name's Kay. Kayla, I think I know her. It's my girlfriend. She said, would you rather fight 100 chicken-sized horses or one horse-sized chicken? I'm gonna go with 100 chicken-sized horses. Because one horse-sized chicken would be friggin' terrifying, so I'm good on that. And I think I'd still kick its butt. And also, I wouldn't mind like fighting Kayla either, because why not? Angela Burbank said, "How is it to work with CJ, CJ and Dylan? Are they pranksters or are they serious?" Working with them, like when it comes to work, the work always is very serious. The work gets done. There's no playing around when it comes to work. But their personalities are always joking, light, and just fun. So all in all, it's always a good time working with them. Always pranks. I know on the last trip, it's just whether it's like waking you up, scaring you, waking you up, or jumping out of a closet at you when you walk by. You know, it's always a good time. So lots of fun. Always a good time with the boys. I promise you, I need to vlog more of that stuff next time I'm with them because it is a riot. Definitely more time laughing than there is not laughing. That's the truth. Triple Blast said, "What do you do before and after an investigation to protect yourself?" Personally, I like to pray. Just growing up Catholic, I pray a lot. So I do pray like before, during, and after. Most of the time during, when I'm like super scared, I'm just like, please God help me. Again, I support whatever your religious beliefs are. It's not saying that that's what works for everybody, but I like to pray. So that's me. But yeah, lots of prayers, holy water when I get home, just the things that I do, and I've had pretty good luck for the most part, so knock on wood. I don't think that's wood, but knock on wood, but we've been all right so far. What do you use to reconstitute powdered water? If anybody knows what that means, can you like let me know in the comments? I have no idea. That's from the Yodeling Mime. All right. Laura Graham said, "Question: some YouTubers fake things just to get content. What do you think about that?" Yeah, I know for a fact people that do that. All I can really say is that YouTube is an entertainment platform, and I don't know. I don't think that faking things is the best. Like, I don't think it's great. Like, I think it sucks that people do have to fake things, but at the same time, you go on YouTube to be entertained. I don't think people go on YouTube to watch, just go there for real content all the time. Because again, like when you watch TV, I'm sorry, but a lot of the stuff you watch on TV is not real. Even the stuff you think, like with the Bigfoot and the Yetis and UFOs, like how do you know? Like, you don't know what's actually real in that. Like, it's just entertainment. It's stuff to get you by. And if you want to like watch real stuff, you gotta look for it or go do it yourself, you know? Like, there's real stuff out there. But I think YouTube would be much less entertaining and like fun to watch if everything was totally real and not sometimes, you know, fake or just emphasized a little bit. I don't know. I guess everyone has different opinions on it. I'm not like, again, like we're content creators. Like, you have to create content. You have to make content. You have to, like not always like make things happen, but sometimes things don't happen. So you want to, you know, spice it up, or sometimes people just like emphasize things that happen. Like, you hear a noise and you make it, like, you're more scared. Like, I don't know. I think it's just basic. I think that's just basic stuff. I'm not saying that, like, I'm fake or people around me are fake. Like, we put a lot of time, effort, and work into our videos. And the ghost hunting stuff, all the stuff I've been on has always been legit and real and terrifying. So there's always going to be people out there that fake things. But at the end of the day, sometimes it makes good content. So I say if that's what works for them, I say go for it. You know, there's people out there like Stromedy who, like, makes clown videos. Like, you really think that's real? And if you have to question if it's real, it's probably not, you know? Like, if it crosses that line for you and you're like, wow, that's not real, it probably isn't real. But if you like it, keep watching it. Who cares? Like, there's still content creators. They're still going out there and they're out filming. They're putting the work in. The videos don't film themselves. So I guess all I'm saying is that, you know, it's YouTube. If you like somebody for who they are, like, watch their videos. You don't have to like it for the realism. You don't go to the movies and say, man, that was such a great real movie. Like, everything you watch in the movies is fake. It's all set up. It's scripted. It's all actors. Think about the stuff you watch on YouTube and how good some of the videos are with these low budgets, like people just walking around with cameras. And I don't know. I'm just saying, like, some of it's really good content. So, yeah, like, have your own opinions on it. Think whatever you want to think. And, you know, it is what it is. Television, sorry if I said your name wrong, sorry if I butchered some of these names, asked a few questions, but how do you like being on your own? I do like being on my own, just it's a good challenge, and I'm trying to get better at being uncomfortable and trying new things. So having to do my own grocery shopping and cooking, and I can't afford to DoorDash every meal, you know, so I gotta cook, and I've been doing a bunch of that, which has been fun, and it's healthier. I feel like I'm more motivated to go to the gym and do things and try to better myself, so I've been A lot of it's good. A lot of it's been really good. I'm really happy about it. What are some of the challenges you faced, if any, being away from parents, family, girlfriend? It's really just that, being away from them, you know, like not being able to, like, hey, mom and dad, like, I have a question or I need some advice. You know, the phones are always on, but, you know, actually being there and just sitting with them after work or having dinner with them and spending time with my girlfriend, like, it trust me, it really sucks. But I chose to make the sacrifice for not just myself, but for my girlfriend and my family, because I believe in myself and I believe that I, you know, have the ability to do more and to make more of life, and I have good people around me that want to help me and see me grow and succeed, so I'm going to do everything I possibly can to make that happen. And if it means me being 20 hours from home, sucks, but I'm going to give them my all, I promise you that. Shelly B said, is it as good as you thought it would be in Florida? Cannot handle the heat, lol. It is. No, it's very good. Alright, scared me. I wasn't ready for that. Drink some coffee and recover. That was a ghost. Do it again. We're good. Yeah, so it definitely is. It's definitely nice here. I don't mind the heat. I'm always good with the heat because I can't stand snow and I hate the cold. So the heat's been fine. Again, traffic sucks. The people aren't great. I know there's big snakes around. I don't like snakes. It's good and bad, you know, and it's very, very fast paced in a lot of aspects. So I've been enjoying it. It's been good. It's been a nice change. I'm not sure how I'll feel about it in the summertime when it's even hotter, but we'll see about that. But yeah, we've been okay. We're living it. We're not hating it yet. You know, it's been good. What do we got here? From Mary Easley. Just said, may your dreams and goals reward you with endless possibilities. Remember your roots. Remind yourself how to be humble without being reminded. You'll succeed at anything. Help you reflect on your journey to checking off that dream and why. Oh, real estate is a great direction. With your first sale, how will you reflect on your journey to checking off that dream? I don't know. I really haven't, like, thought about that yet. I mean, I definitely think a lot all day, every day. So I'm definitely not going to be unappreciative or anything. I know I'm absolutely grateful for the opportunities and the people who've helped me get to where I am. And when the first sale, you know, does happen, when that time comes, I'm probably going to thank a bunch of people. You know, I'm going to be very grateful. I'm never going to forget that, for sure. You know, it's a big, big challenge, something I've always wanted to go after and try. So yeah, I don't know. That's a deep one too. I wish I had more time to think about it because I'm getting low on battery and memory cards. So thank you, Mary. Sorry that I don't have a better answer for you, but I'm going to keep rolling here. Gary Jones said, if you could be a fly on a wall for a day, who would you spy on? So I would definitely fly my butt over to Area 51, like ASAP, right to Nevada. I don't know how I'd get there. Maybe I have to, like, jump on an airplane or something. But yeah, I'm going to Area 51, and it's going to be crazy. I'm going to go in there, and I'm going to look up all the alien spaceships. I'm going to get in one of the hangars. I'm going to get in an alien ship. I'm going to figure out where the aliens are, where they keep the bodies. Like, I want to see everything. That's my biggest thing. Like, if aliens are real for somehow, in some way, like, I wish we had the option. I wish they would be like, if you want to see them, you want to see a ship, you're welcome to. If you don't want to see it, don't want to believe it, then don't. I hate the secrecy part of it because it's so fascinating to me. You know, I mean, the universe is so big. Like, not to be like that person, like, oh, it's so big, man. Like, we're so small. But, like, really, like, the universe is huge. And I would love to know more about it and more about other life and other forms. That stuff doesn't scare me. Like, it's very interesting. And this is kind of, like, off topic, but not really. I know a lot of people don't like Joe Rogan, and that's fine. You don't have to like him. This isn't political or anything. But he did a podcast with Bob Lazar. Bob Lazar used to work at Area 51. And I think maybe I talked about this last time. But if you're looking for a good podcast to listen to about aliens and, like, alien ships, it, like, changed my life forever. So check out the one with Bob Lazar and Joe Rogan. It's a really good episode. Michelle Owens asked, what's one huge thing on your bucket list? So for me, that would have to be, like, traveling. Like, the biggest things on my bucket list are definitely, like, places I want to go to. Japan's probably the biggest one right now. I'm just super fascinated with Japan. I guess it's maybe the culture, more or less, the cities and just the food. I love Japanese food. There's no lying about that. And food's a big part of my life. As you can see, I like to eat. So, yeah, I like that. I like that a lot. But yeah, I want to travel. I want to get to that point in the next 10 to 20 years where I can really just slow down, take time off, and travel when I want to travel. Hopefully people are still watching YouTube at that point, and we can do all this stuff, you know, still travel and do things and make money. So that's the goal here. What's upcoming in your videos? Vlog content, maybe some racing content? That's from Lisa Kelch. Yes, absolutely. Vlog content for sure, like this one right here. And racing content for sure if I can get to the track. I've been super busy and have not been able to get to the track like I wanted to. So hopefully we will get there soon. Melanie Fulton asked if I would go back to the Goose on the Roof and do a 3 a.m. challenge again. And absolutely, that place was really cool. I was a little nervous at first, but overall, when we got, you know, done with it in the morning, nothing really happened in my part of the building. If you guys didn't get to watch that video with CJ, check it out. We stayed at an antique store overnight. It was crazy. We didn't have like a ton of activity, but there's one piece of thing that happened with a Jack in the Box at like 3:30 or 4 in the morning or something. It was crazy. So if you guys check that out, it was also a super funny video. I think I've watched it back a few times just because it's so funny. Catch me snoring and sleeping. CJ was making fun of me. So that was a good one. Thanks for the love, Melanie. Appreciate you. Mandy Pritchard said, "Hey Chris, if you were left on an island all on your own, what would be the three things that you would take with you?" First of all, I'm taking a huge like solar charger thing, some kind of portable charger, solar powered, of course. That's number one. Number two, I would probably want something to cook things in, so like a pan, maybe like a good size, like a big pan or a pot or something that I could like make fire with. And then three would be something to start a fire with, for sure. Like some kind of fire starter, the rocks or whatever, because I'm not going to lie, starting a fire with sticks does not sound fun at all. I don't want to do that every night. So that's going to be my three things. Solar charger. Why do I need the solar charger, though, if I don't have, like, a phone or anything, right? I guess that's pretty stupid. I'm going to bring it anyways, just in case I find, like, a phone or something lying around. Mother of Coincidences said, "What is your favorite color?" I'm going to go with blue. But I also do like the color, like coral, like a corally orange is also like super cool. I like that a lot. Would you do any random awkward videos with yourself? Absolutely. That's from Reverend Lori Ganta. And what is your most terrifying one? Probably still going to be the Saratoga Homestead for me. Or maybe going up the mountain when we went to the ruins out in Socrates, New York. That walk to the top was super scary in the dark. So we did that a couple times. Parky2685 asked, "Hey Chris, how difficult is it to learn how to use, you know, Parky asked how difficult it is to edit and use photo and video editing software. It's really not hard at all. My biggest thing would be to just try to use it yourself, figure out what you want to do, see if you can do it. And if you don't know how, watch YouTube videos. There's so many good YouTube reviews out there. Adobe Premiere Pro is like the easiest software you could ever use, I swear to you. It's not hard at all, so... give it a try. Don't get down like if you can't figure it out. Somebody else has had the same issue as you, I promise you. But spend a couple hours watching YouTube videos and you'll pick it up quick. It's really not bad. I'm going to do a couple more because there's 6 minutes left on this memory card. So, what was the most challenging thing you've ever done? I ran 12 miles over the summer. Like I only stopped, I think, once or twice, like a quick brisk like walk, catch my breath and kept going. So that was one of the hardest things I ever did. And it was super, super good feeling when I was done. I need to get back on that. I want to do a marathon before all is said and done. So hopefully next year I can do like a half marathon or a marathon. But yeah, I did 12 miles over the summer. It was a good feeling. All right. Angel asked a random question. Are you ever going to cut your hair? Hopefully not. Definitely not. I'm going to trim it up here and there, but I'm loving the flow. I've always wanted to have this. So just like a little childhood goal. Plus I'm getting old and I might start falling out soon. So why not grow my hair out, right? This one's from Chris Baird. Sounds familiar. It said, "Junior, will you ever put your dirt bike back together from your initial road trip, or does dad need to fly out and help you?" Oh, I know that guy. That's my dad. yeah, I haven't been able to put my dirt bike back together yet. I've been super busy. So, if you can fly out, dad, and you want to help do it, I'd appreciate it. But, I'm gonna try to get to it this week. I'm capable of doing it. I've just been busy. So, love you, dad. Love you, mom. I miss you guys so much. I got a bunch of other good questions here, and I'll try to answer them. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Do you have any college degrees planned? I don't plan on going back to college. I don't always plan on taking courses or reading books to better myself, but no more college for me. Not my thing. In 5 years, I would love to be set in stone in some kind of career. I'd like to be a little bit more stable than I am now. Love to have my family a little bit closer to me, like wherever I'm at. And I'd love to have my own place and a newer vehicle. That's just the simple things for me. So those are the few that I picked. I know it wasn't all of them, but... Oh, the last one I'll do right now. C. Marie Taylor asked how my mental health is. And are you handling the changes well? So my mental health's actually been great. I think it's because of the sunshine, warmer weather. New York winters are very depressing, and I mean that. Like, just gray, not much sunshine, like, for 4 or 5 months. Cold, miserable. Sun's out, like, once a week. Just not good. It's not good for your mind. It's not good for your brain. It's not good for anything. So I really recommend that people... If you can get out and get away from, you know, the Northeast in the wintertime, like, please do. It's really good for you. I wish more people could, because just like, you got to get out. Like, the sunshine is so important and so good for you and so good for your mood and making you happy. At least for me, my mood is very dependent on, like, how it is outside. If it's cold and rainy, I'm just like, whatever. Let's go do something inside. Let's go sit on the couch. But I'm an active person. I love to be outside doing things, so... this weather has been very helpful for that, although I'm working in an office space now, so it's like one of those things, like, not outside as much as I want to, but yeah, I'll figure it out. But yeah, I'm gonna wrap this up right now. I'll probably answer some more questions in a little bit here for the old vlog channel, not the vlog channel, but yeah, I'm gonna wrap this up, guys. I'll probably answer more questions for my behind the scenes stuff. I do have a Patreon now. If you guys join my Patreon at $10 a month or more, you do get access to Discord. Not a money grab. This, again, that's going to help me travel more and create more content for you guys. So if you want to join, I believe it's patreon.com/ChrisBaird if you want to join that. Never ask for monetary donations. You don't have to. But if you'd like to join and support me, you're more than welcome to. Hope I'm not contradicting myself. I'm offering that for people. Every one of my patrons, I've listed them in the beginning of the video. Amazing people. I'm so glad and happy to have them. So... yeah, thank you guys so much. It's been fun. I like doing videos. I like recording videos. This flew by. It went by so fast. I can't believe it's already so late here. I'm going to get to work editing this and try to get this uploaded for everybody. So thanks for watching. Again, I know it's not the most exciting video. I've been doing a lot of talking in the past few. But stay tuned. I'm going to get some more good content out for everybody. Randonautica, ghost hunting, magnet fishing, whatever I can for everybody. I try to go over this cold. But yeah, we'll get there. It's going to take a little bit, but we'll get there. A little bit at a time. So I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for supporting me and being here with me. And yeah, catch you guys in the next video. Peace.